Hi everybody, it's Carly the Pink Scrapper, and today I have a couple projects I'm working on, probably about three of them cluttering my desk right now. So, anyways, I got to the end of this spool, and I seem to get a lot of these, and I just save them. And I was going to make a pin cushion, but then for some reason I saw something else. So I'm not going to tell you what I'm going to make with this. You're just going to have to watch. Okay, so I'm going to recycle this, of course, upcycle, whatever you want to call it. So the first thing I needed was this is quilt batting, and when you work at 2 o'clock in the morning, you just use what you have around. So you can use felt. At first I was going to use some fabric, but I kind of liked the finish of this one better than fabric. So the other thing is I've got this extra, because what I did is I cut two circles from the shape of my spool, and then I got this extra, but I'm going to keep this because when I do my pin cushion, I'm going to have some extra padding there. Okay, and then I measured the width of the spool right here, and that was 1 3/4, and so I cut a strip that's 1 3/4. And then I just kept going, and hopefully this is enough to go around it. I think it is. So anyways, that's the three pieces I'm going to start with. And then I'm going to need some of this stuffing, because I'm going to stuff it in here. That's probably a little bit too much, but anyways, let me grab my glue gun, and we are going to get started. Okay, so here's my trusty glue gun, and I'm going to try these finger caps, I think is what they call them. This is a new product that I'm trying out, and these are specifically made for your glue gun, so you don't burn your fingers. And I got a few other tools as well. This came in the kit along with a glue mat. And it's pink, which I love. No problem there. But I already have this pink heat resistant and, you know, stain resistant mat here. So I don't really need to use that. And so I'm going to save that. And these are the pieces. And this pink silicone you see is nonstick. So you can use these. This one, I can't remember the name of it, but it's basically to spread glue or to push down. So it looks actually like a glue stick to me. But and then here's another little spatula. So you get three of these fingers, and I'm going to just try using two. So the first thing I want to do is I'm going to glue my top down, and cover this up, and then I'm going to get this started so that I can have something to push the batting into. Okay, so there's that, and let's just go around a little bit, I guess. Well, let's push a little bit in here, and I'm going to use this little guy. And I'm just putting this batting in so that there's a form in here, so it's just not flopping around. Okay, so I've got this completely covered and stuffed, and then I made another one. Anyways, it's going to go like that. So let's get a lot of glue here, and I want to push it down as much as I can so it stays glued down and it's not too lumpy. Okay, so there's that. So that's what I have so far. And then I pulled out a bunch of laces and trims, and I want to cover the sides, and so I kind of did something like that. Okay, so I've got the ivory crocheted lace around this base, and now I'm going to put this one around this base. Okay, so there's that, and I'm not going to worry about the top yet because I can trim it and then just fold it down like that. So I'm just worried about getting this down here at the base for now. So now I need to look at this and see what I want to do with this top here. And it's actually too long, so I'm going to cut some off, which I hate to do, but it's such pretty lace. All right. So there that one goes. I'm just going to gather it up at the top like that. And here's more glue. And here we go. Whoops. Whoops. Alright, so let's get it all at the top here. Pull it a little tight. Okay, so I think I'm going to put these two around the base and put another one up at the top, and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back, and I kind of went crazy on this, so let me show you where I am. So I put another layer of this white lace on there just so I could cover this section up. And then I put the pink braid and these, then I put this ribbon around the whole thing. And then I added this little dainty pearl trim that I had in my scraps. And that just helps it define this layer right here. So if you haven't guessed it already, this is a cake. It's a two-layer cake, and the reason I thought about this when I looked at the spool is because Kaylee just had her birthday. So, anyways, reminded me of a cake. So I have these three I Am Roses flowers that I just kind of twirled together, but I thought they would be beautiful at the top here. So I'm going to twist this a little bit and then cut off this wire and get rid of that. And then I'll take this and bend it in so I can have like a little thing to grab there. Okay, it looks good. I'm going to put a blob of glue so my flowers never move, and I'm going to put some stickles on this to bling it up because I like bling. And okay, so that is the front, and then I'm debating if I need something even more on the bottom, which I probably do, but I'm not quite sure what I'm going to put on there yet. Okay, I'm back, and you can see I've kind of got this big mess going on, but I really like how this is turning out. Let's see, there you go. I went ahead and glued this bow of seam binding, and then I sprayed the seam binding and just scrunched it up and dried it so it was curly. And I also put this trim here on the bottom. And you can even spray perfume on it. And if you really want to go one step further, you could even have filled some of the spool with potpourri. That would have been really cool, huh? Alright, so they're evenly placed, and I only put four of them on there, but that's okay. I have an extra one. And so I think that's it. I'll take a couple pictures and post it up on my blog so you guys can see. And my blog is pinkscrapper99.blogspot.com. It's a little thread there. So anyways, I hope you like it. I had so much fun doing this. You know I love to do altered projects. And when I can recycle, that's even better. So hope you try this and let me know how it turns out. Thanks for watching. Bye.